Audiobooks.com presents Smart But Scattered Teens, the Executive Skills Program for Helping Teens Reach Their Potential by Richard Guare, PhD, Peg Dawson, EDD, and Colin Guare. Read for you by Abby Craden. Smart But Scattered Teens offers several forms to help you work through the ideas and concepts presented in the book. As you listen to the audiobook, remember that you can download these aids anytime at getaudiophile.com/scattered. That's getaudiophile.com/scattered. Introduction. Worrying about our teens comes with the job of parenting. We cross our fingers when they say goodbye on their way out the door on a Friday night, feel their frustration when they furrow their brows and agonize over schoolwork, wonder if they'll ever survive on their own when we spot a backpack sitting by the door, left behind and full of work that won't make it in on time without a parental delivery service. Parenting a teen through adolescence can be hard in the best of circumstances. Yet for some parents, the years from 14 to 19 are doubly difficult. If your teen can't seem to manage daily responsibilities or even minor problems, you undoubtedly find yourself worrying about these issues much more frequently than other parents. For you, the struggle to surmount your teen's ongoing problems, to strive to raise a self-sufficient, accountable adult, may feel like a never-ending battle. You know your teen is smart enough, and sometimes you marvel at how really bright and creative your son or daughter can be. Just look at the things your teen can accomplish. So why is the morning routine still more chaotic than orderly? Why can't your teen seem to organize belongings and remember to take along whatever is needed for school, for a practice or a game, for a job or a college interview? Why are papers typically late? Appointments missed or never scheduled to begin with? The teen's room in disarray? Why do you have to hold your breath whenever your teen takes the car or has open-ended plans with friends? Your teen is probably trying, and trying hard, to do everything his or her peers are expected to do as they mature and face increasing responsibilities. But it's a daily struggle when the teen has a deficiency in what are called executive skills, the functions of our brains and thought processes that help us regulate our behavior, set goals and meet them, and balance demands and desires, wants, needs, and have-tos. We've written this book to explain why your teen at one minute can seem so capable, and at the next minute, can't get out of his or her own way, to tell you that it's not a lack of smarts, or deliberate defiance, or just being a teenager. Even more important, we've written this book to give you strategies that can help. Methods that have been shown to build the skills your teen lacks in full measure, as well as tactics that will help your teen work around a weak skill and get the job done in a way that plays to the teen's strengths. This may not be the first time you've had to deal with your teen's struggles. Perhaps even when your son or daughter was younger, you had to be on top of the child all the time about one thing or another. If that's the case, you may already have benefited from the practical help in our first book, Smart But Scattered. Voluminous feedback has told us that these methods are as effective when used by parents as they've proven to be in our research and clinical work in schools and private practice. That was a major impetus for the writing of this book. Whether your child has been struggling for years or looked pretty capable in grade school, the child is a teen now, demanding independence and on the verge of adulthood. Your daughter is insistent about making her own decisions and has made it clear that she doesn't want you to meddle in her affairs. Your teenage son wants to run his own life. If your teenager can't do so, what's going to happen? Is your teen going to get hurt? Is your child going to fail? Are you going to have to help your son or daughter manage forever? This book is dedicated to offering the same kinds of help and support we provided in our first book, but with a particular emphasis on the realities of adolescence. With ever-growing responsibilities, a relentless drive to become independent, and a lot more influence from the outside world, particularly peers, your teen can no longer rely so much on you for assistance. And you can no longer expect your teen to accept it as much, as often, or in as many domains of the teen's life as you may like. Adolescence brings new challenges, as you know all too well. Neuroscientists tell us that even teens with good executive skills can struggle at times with the behaviors governed by executive skills. Their brains are going through a critical stage of development, and these executive skills are not yet securely anchored. That's what accounts for the Jekyll and Hyde behaviors of your teen. One minute, your teen is cool, calm, and rational, and the next minute, he's a screaming, irrational, emotional train wreck. If this is the typical teen, imagine the one with executive skills weaknesses. Can't find anything. Mom, where did you put my backpack? Doesn't watch the road. No sense that deadlines really do exist in the world. Willing to try whatever his friends do. If you have a teen with executive skills weaknesses, it's like taking the typical teen and cranking up the volume. Everything is louder, more intense, more scattered. You may have helped your child in the past by using your own executive skills, your own fully developed frontal lobes, to help her learn and compensate. You helped her organize belongings and reminded her where to look when she couldn't find her jacket. You worked with her on her book report and reminded her repeatedly to turn off the TV and attend to her homework. But now you need ways to help your teen without constant fights, and that your teen can accept and still feel like she's in charge of her own life. Neuroscience research tells us that the adolescent brain is primed for the acquisition of new skills. Teens are driven to seek out new experiences, more intense social and emotional relationships, and, for better or worse, new risks. While it can be cause for worry, this new quest for independence presents teens with daily opportunities to use executive skills. And it presents you with a chance to help your teen improve these skills. But if your goal is to see your teen develop executive skills and become independent, your role as a parent must be quite different from what it has been until now. Your teen wants the chance to try out her ideas, make her own decisions. So part of your job will change from leading to following her lead. Now you'll work through negotiation and compromise and positive communication. You'll encourage her to set and follow her goals and offer help if she wants it, even if her goals don't always match yours. Before you panic, let's be clear. You're not going to give up your role as parent. You will still have clear expectations for school and home, for standards of behavior and rules, about curfew, behavior with friends, drugs and alcohol, driving, etc. And above all, your job, as it always has been, is to keep your teen in the game. Protect him from catastrophic risks and failures. But this doesn't mean you protect the teen from all mistakes or failures. When these occur, you help the teen get up and dust himself off, if he won't accept your help, and encourage him to give it another try. Your role now is to be a facilitator, a catalyst, and not a tiger mom or dad. At times, you probably wish there were some magic bullet, a pill, a spell, a dietary supplement that would infuse your teen with whatever executive skills he or she seems to lack. Wouldn't it be great if there were a fabulous new product that could meet your needs? Execu spray, screams the infomercial that runs through your mind. Simply spray your teen every morning with this miracle remedy and watch your teen finish homework. Remember to walk the dog. Resolve conflicts with the grace of a diplomat. And maintain a spick-and-span bedroom and organized notebooks and much, much more. We'd all pay a lot for such a cure to ease our own worry and make life easier for the teens we care so much about. We know they can go far, and our fondest wish is to help them get there. That's what this book is all about. It will take effort and commitment, but we've given you lots of tips for boosting your success rate with our strategies by knowing your teen's strengths and weakness as well as your own. The way you two interact, and the personality traits you each...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.